Someone in passing mentioned the age of the air. Somebody spoke of flight. The age of flight. Begin from there. The theory, if you can call it a theory, went like this. We move about in certain spheres, certain elements. Now those elements are, one, the ground, over and along and under the ground. And two, the water, along the water and under the water. But also conceivably, just possibly, don't let this throw you. Three, the air. We might be airborne. We might sit on the air. We might even tread the air. Lifted on wings, you and I. Under us, supported by speed. Power driving us, power of motors. So much for the theory. A dream, really. Question: how long have men had such a dream? The answer comes pat. You know what a man is. He's dreamed of flying in the air ever since the first time he tried and found he couldn't. Laugh it off. This little thought knocks out a mountain range, tears up the jungle. This notion eats oceans, puts the desert in its vest pocket, has geography for tea. The barriers to the other side of the world, they can pack it up now and call it a day. They're through. Something called an idea rubbed them out. I said, don't let it throw you. Don't let it throw you. This little notion, this thought, this dream, don't go overboard. No, just tell the stories. Wasn't there something about a magic carpet? Wings on shoes, wings on shoulders. Angels, harpies. Fairies, witches, history, and mythology? Tell the stories!
Etana jumped on the back of an eagle in Mesopotamia, tried to fly in 4500 B.C., but he got dizzy, got got dizzy and tumbled off. Got dizzy, tumbled off, and fell and died. Old Etana had wings on the brain.
To the airborne.
There was Python, son of the sun, Apollo, and he stole his sun wagon, but he didn't know how to steer that wagon. When it rose up, we froze. When it dropped on down, we sizzled. Going up and down, we froze and sizzled by turn. That was Python and wings on the brain.
Wings on the brain, wings on the brain.
Father, by the sky we will essay to go, but Icarus attached his wings with tallow, and he flew near the sun, and the tallow melted down, and the wings came off, and Icarus plummeted down to the sea. That was Icarus, and wings on the brain.
Wings on the brain, wings on the
shining. Air was cold and bright. A couple of brothers, the brothers right, stood round, gave orders, lent a hand. When out of its shed on the big gray field was wheeled the contraption, the construction, the plane. You, will you be the one? You 12 horsepower dream up. Will you be the one? No other. There you go. Milton Wright received a telegram. Success. 4 flights Thursday morning. Inform press. Home Christmas. Orville Wright. Kittyhawk, North Carolina. December 17, 1903. An enemy. You know what a man is. He yearns. He destroys. He kills. He builds. Men are airborne. Airborne out of the sky comes the threat. Connect two facts. this gardener whistling under the somewhere sunlight, and one other fact, 20 men being stood against a wall. Connect two facts, the record hop to California by flyers from Russia, and one other fact, the rich and well-placed Italian stating that the bombs from his plane over Spain exploded on people, opened like a rose, and proved great sport. Should marry only a blonde Aryan woman with blue, wide-open eyes, a long oval face, a pink and white skin, a narrow nose, a small mouth, and under all circumstances, virginal.
Hate!
Holy!
Guernica, Warsaw, Manila, Rotterdam, London, Malta, Leningrad. Still digging. Wait. I thought I heard a child crying. Under there. No. It stopped now.
Are a silent love.
Malta, London, Rotterdam, Manila, Warsaw, Guernica, get out of bed, young British pilot. Come on, go walking on the wind-still sky. Cold dawn is lovely for a promenade, a ceiling scarcely limited what we call. Forget the angry, obsessed night, the corruption of waiting. Forget you saw descend in a black flame, dropping his heart and identity card before him before he leapt. A guy, and looked, and lost, and bought it. Clean the air, young pilot. You held them. Remember that. You held them. This morning is this morning. Come on out. Hop a flight in anybody's ship. Jump in, take off alone. Those clothy clouds unlit by the early sun are pavement now. Move out to the early sun. Falling leaf, a full half minute happily upside down. A next 2 minutes, all improvisation. The craft upon its belly, on its side, and mounting almost vertical and stopping to change its mind and float. Uh-oh, a slow roll, my error. Relax, idle about, and then return. Come back. Come home, and still no one to talk to. No one up yet. Good. Climb down, young pilot. Get a little earth dirt on your shoes. Pat the dog on his joyful ears. Young British pilot, be comforted. Feel better.
You know him, the young American. Fresh from high school, straight out of college, green from the office and the farm and the shop and factory. The brash, the young, the funny, the noble, the brash, young, funny, noble American. Ground crew suddenly turned Air Force overnight. Iris in, train down. Focus on him for one example.
Hurry up and wait. hurry up, and stop. Mistake. Go back. Wrap your guns up. And wait. And wait. And wait. Little things we'd like to know.
Clear the props.
Props clear.
Everyone, battle positions. Gunners, on your toes.
Here we go.
Sorry, the mission is scrubbed. The side is retired.
Is that correct? The side is retired? Cut the engines?
That is correct. Cut your engines.
Take off your thick electric gloves and your
Foo bar.
night, a white-faced 19-year-old bombardier sits writing the wonder of his crew tonight before the flight. It's writing, behold the stern precision of time and plan. Regard one sudden man in a given hour. The hand, the eye, the deliberate brow, this veteran now sits writing a letter home. I take my pen in hand, Emily, to make you understand what you are to me. I write as far as dear Emily and cannot make it clear what you are to me. My heart's one cry, foolish words that I wish to say and try so terribly. The words are like a wall, Emily. I cannot write at all what you are to me. You are my heart's one cry. If you were nearby, you could tell me why. Write me, you will be true, Emily. Write me, I am to you what you are to me. A white-faced 19-year-old bombardier sits writing the wonder of his crew tonight before the flight sits writing.
The plane.
Iris out. Bombardier to crew. Crew to squadron. Squadron to group.
The plane.
The sky.
You cannot see the sky.
All plane.
Iris out. Group to wing. Wing to command. Command to the command of the air might of the nations. On the prowl, on the march, the planes, the planes!
Sound the sound of all the nations speaking to the rendezvous. Sound the sound of rally as they march.
One threat is down. Thankfulness, not without grief. Thankfulness, not without grief. The bright morning, not without warning. Watch this victory. Whose victory? Whose glory? Shall men, once again ready to resume the conquest of the skies, once again, be stopped. Once again, create the enemy. Watch this victory. Blessing and the bright morning to the airborne. Not without warning to the airborne. not without grief, not without warning,